The Devidians must have found some way to generate a portal at the station so that they can feed on the humans in the past. While the humans are no friends of ours, a shift in the balance of power in that sector of space could have drastic repercussions. There is no telling if it would be positive for the Empire or not. We cannot take chances. You must head through the Devidian portal into the past and find out how they are creating the temporal fluctuations. Fortunately, the Federation in the 23rd century will never recognize a Klingon from our time, so you may be able to pass unnoticed. Oh, and just in case, don't kill anyone. We wouldn't want to accidentally change the course of history. Keep your team small, for similar reasons. Everything we do is for the Empire!
Welcome to Drozanna. What? I mean, who are you? I've never seen anyone who looked like you before. The station is on medical alert. Nobody's supposed to be in the computer core area but me. Hey, is that a weapon? Don't try anything, or I'll have to stun you. The lift shouldn't have let you come down to this level. How did you get here? You should have used the intercom to call for assistance. It's not safe. Follow me. I'm going to call security for an escort. I guess you're right. Look, just go up to the maintenance lift, get to the emergency medical center as soon as possible, and get checked out. There's a doctor up there who has set up a triage center for the affected patients.
You shouldn't be here. You should get up to the quarantine area. Oh, just running a level 3 diagnostic on the subsystem. The computers on this station are state-of-the-art. I can simulate an entire copy of the station and display every piece of it as a wireframe model. I'm really busy with this diagnostic. Sorry. You really should go up to the quarantine area. Excuse me. Oh, hey! You shouldn't be here. You should get up to the quarantine area. Oh, just running a level 3 diagnostic. I know, isn't it? I'm very fortunate to be able to work here. Working on a station like this really strikes home just how modern and new everything is. Yes, although it has its own memory and subprocessor as well, it can even work in parallel with the computer core's main processor. Here, I'll show you. That's odd. The core isn't responding to my request. I need to go talk to Lieutenant Myers. Make sure you get up to the quarantine area and get checked out by the doctor.
Thank you. Enemy target on sensors. Personal shield losing power.
Thank you.
So Driffin's comet is the source of the triolic radiation. Interesting. That explains a great deal. We cannot simply destroy it in our time. The Devidians have the means to go back to the 23rd century and harness its energy there. However, that will be their only other chance. Before that, there's no Drozanna Station, so there's no place that will be close enough to the comet's trajectory to be of use to them. The only logical solution is to alter the past, destroy the comet there, and save the Empire. As it happens, I have access to a way to transport your ship back to the 23rd century. It's dangerous, but the alternative is much worse. Check in for new orders regularly. I will let you know when we are ready for this operation. Everything we do is for the Empire. Everything we do is for the Empire.
Attention, unidentified ship. I am Commodore Jacob Ross in command of the USS Reuben James. We have been searching for a Klingon vessel reported to have attacked a colony in the Gliese system. You fit the description of the ship we are looking for. Unless you can prove you are not, we will take immediate action.
Are, but they're all over the station. They're killing people. Please, you have to help us.
not attempt to stop us. We hunger. We must feed. Leave immediately, or I will amplify the time distortion and destroy this station. You will not survive.
Hey, those things are holed up in the lounge, and they've got some of my customers in there with them. The door is barricaded, but a few hits with a phaser should take care of that. Get my people out of there!
My, you're a funny-looking one, aren't you? Thanks for the help, friend. What were those things? Damn spirit snuck up on me. I noticed a spike in triolic energy, and I was working to adjust the station's shields to compensate. I went to fetch a hyperspatter, and I was attacked! If you help me, I can finish my repairs before the triolic energy reaches lethal levels. By the way, you can call me Scotty. Just as I suspected, the triolic energy is increasing. We'll be cooked like a haggis if we don't do something about it. There is a wee store on this station. The lass who runs it, Cassidy, said they might be getting a supply of the new quantum flux regulators. The Mark II versions. If we had one of those regulators, I could modify the flux coordinating sensors and use them to modulate the shields protecting the station. That would buy us some time. Go find Cassidy. She'll know where.
Things. They were floating, and everyone looked at me, and I felt so weak. And then it lifted me up, and oh, it was horrible. Oh, are you looking for something from the store? A quantum what? I'm sorry. I'm just too scared right now to think about selling anything. I'm closing down until I get my wits about me. Maybe it would be best if I packed up and went back to Sherman's planet. I don't know. Oh, I don't know. Maybe a nerve tonic would soothe me. A nice stiff one, you know. Can you get one for me? Who do you think you are? First the lights go all strange, then these weird creatures show up, and worst of all, you're here picking fights with my best customers. Look at dear, brave, handsome Captain McQueen here. He could have been killed. You should be ashamed of yourself. Nerve tonics. How could I think about nerve tonics when my sweet Captain McQueen is injured? Well, if you want to know about any sort of exotic beverage, go ask that drunken Scotsman. Lieutenant Commander Scott. He knows more about alcohol than anyone I've ever met. While you do that, I'm going to make my sweet prince all better.
Every culture in the galaxy has nerve tonics. Most worlds have multiple variations, and everyone thinks that the one their grandmother made is better than all the rest. Look, I tend bar at a commerce station in the middle of one of this quadrant's busiest trade routes. It's my job to be able to make anything you want, but you gotta be specific. I could make you 14,647 different nerve tonics, 18,397 if you're bowling it. So, what kind do you want? Tell you what, one of the waitresses should be able to help you narrow down what kind of nerve tonic would be best. Talk to one of them, and then come back. I'm sure we can make exactly what you need.
Did you get the quantum flux regulator? Nerve tonics? Ugh! You don't look like you need one of those. These wee beasties are troublesome, but they're not as bad as a ship full of angry Romulans. Now, I've been known to enjoy an occasional nip of Scotch whiskey. That's the only nerve tonic you'll ever need. Why do you need to know about them? Oh, for Cassidy. Now that makes sense. She's a bonny lass, that Cassidy, and more than willing to spend a little time with the right Starfleet officer, if you know what I mean. But she hasn't got the stomach for fighting. Is she all right? I hate for everything to happen to her. Glad to hear it. Sounds like she needs something to take a wee bit of the edge off. And that happens to be one of my specialties, along with transwarp transporter technology and warp field mechanics. Cassidy's been meeting me every evening in the bar for a spot of cheer, but I've never seen her order a nerve tonic. Perhaps if I told you what she likes, you'll be able to figure out the right mix. The bartender will help you. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Cassidy didn't like the salty taste of the Albion brandy, but she really enjoyed the fact that it was garnished with a drop of honey that floated on the top of the drink. Bah, garnish is getting in the way of a fine beverage, if you ask me. Can you imagine putting a wee piece of pineapple in a glass of 20-year-old single malt? It's preposterous. I've seen Cassidy. The only time I saw Cassidy ordering blood wine was when she was feeling under the weather. Poor lass. She liked that it was served warm, but she hated those blasted heavy metal mugs the Klingons use. And the potency of it was a bit much for her to handle. A girl like Cassidy needs something with a little less kick. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Zalay brought Cassidy a Denevian mead a few nights ago. Ugh, terribly sweet stuff, like drinking syrup. Cassidy didn't like the cloying sweetness, and the wee bird broke out into hives because she was allergic to the fruit garnish. I'm not ordering any of that stuff again. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Cassie and I got into a drinking contest with a Klingon one night, and we ended up drinking pyro wine. It's not as good as scotch, mind you, but it's better than drinking warp core coolant. The next morning, after she picked herself up off the floor, Cassidy told me that the fire wine was so spicy that she was afraid it had eaten a hole through her stomach. I had to send her to see Bones for a checkup. Also, she said that drinking from those shallow bowls made her feel like someone's pet targ. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Martinis aren't my cup of tea, as it were, but Cassidy seems to like them. She appreciates that a martini should be served as cold as possible, but since she nurses her drinks, the cold tends to dissipate, and she doesn't get the full effect. She's quite fond of those fancy stem glasses, though. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Cassidy really likes her Sumerian sunsets, mostly because of the sour taste. She hates that the drink is so weak, and has been trying to convince the bartender to add garnish to it to make the happy feeling last longer. But he won't, because then it wouldn't be a Sumerian sunset. Me, I say a drink is a drink. If the lady wants a garnish, give her one. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks. Cassidy really likes the little pick-me-up of a drop of Skagerian whiskey. But she doesn't like the wee shot glasses or the silly paper umbrellas. Who ever heard of putting a wee paper umbrella in a glass of whiskey? It's sacrilege. If I ever go to Skagara, I'm going to give them a piece of my mind. I've seen Cassidy order these drinks.
Nerve tonics? How can I think about nerve tonics when my sweet Captain McQueen is...
What can I get you? I'll need some more details before I can make a drink for you. If you need help figuring out what combination of ingredients you want, you should talk to one of the waitresses. That's what they're here for, after all. So, do you want it to be hot or cold? What kind of flavor profile are you looking for? How strong do you want this drink to be? How would you like this drink to be served? And last but certainly not least, what kind of garnish would you like? This should be all the info I need. I'll put the drink on the bar when I'm done. I'll put the bill on your tab. What can I get you?
Have a drink for me. Oh, I love warm drinks. They're so relaxing. Oh, there's a lovely sour note to this drink. I feel so refreshed. Oh, there's just enough oomph to this drink to make it really stick with you. Accentuates the flavor of the ingredients. Honey! No, not you. The drink. Oh, that little bit of sweetness is just perfect. It adds the most delightful note to each sip. Ah, that is marvelous. Oh, I'm feeling much better now, thank you. Alrighty, what tool was it you needed? Oh, a quantum flux regulator Mark II? I have one of those right here. Please, take it as a thank you. Cheers!
Thank you.
The right tool for the right job. I'll start making the adjustments, but I don't know if I've got enough time. You can't change the laws of physics. The triolic energy levels keep rising, and since they're show, the blasted comet is to blame. Modulating the shields is not going to be enough. Something needs to be done about that comet if we're going to live to see the morning.
A ship from the House of Duras! I am Captain Bavot, son of Warot, and leader of my house! My brother died due to Duras' treachery. I will avenge his death with the destruction of 100 Duras ships! Prepare to die!
What?
If you are receiving this message, then you and your crew have completed your mission. Driffin's comet is destroyed, and the Devidians are no longer a threat to the Empire. I thank you for your service to Klingon intelligence. And, because I will never leave one of my people behind, I have found a way to assist you in return. When you last docked at Ganalda Station, I had some modifications made to your vessel. One of those is the addition of a Borg temporal node salvaged from a cube in the Batron cluster. It's set to return you to our time. Congratulations on a job well done. Kopla! Driffin's comet is a memory. I'm sure a Federation scientist will do some meaningless study into its disappearance in the 23rd century. But, like so many of the minutiae those explorers are so fascinated with, it will be of no consequence. What matters is that you acted to protect your empire. You did a warrior's duty. There is no greater reward than that. It would be best for the Empire to keep the details of what transpired here secret. Time travel is so troublesome. But while the lore singers will never tell the tale of your ship and the comet, know that those in power recognize and appreciate your achievements. Go with honor, my friend. I will call on you again in the future, should the need arise. Everything we do is for the Empire.
shield has failed.
Ship is ready. disarm your weapons. You will escort us to your homeworld, where we will begin assimilating your culture and technology.
Thank you.